So, in continuation with the previous thing, that is, in the previous part of the lecture, we saw how your linear strip would operate. So, in continuation with that, we'll try to check out how our circular strip will operate. So, we saw in the previous class this one, that is single sensor, which is generating a 2D image. Now, we'll go ahead and see about your circular sensor, which will be generating a 3D image. So here in this arrangement, what we'll be having is, we'll be having a 3D object, a rod like this. This 3D object will be having a motion, linear motion, that is front and backward. So this would move something like this. This would move something like this around this whole circular motion, circular thing. So on this circular thing, we'll be having an X-ray source, and that X-ray source will be emitting, and the same X-ray source will be collected by the sensor, which is there on the inner part of this thing. Okay, so what will happen, friends? Now you'll be having a circular thing like this. So on in this circular thing, we'll be having the sensors everywhere like this, and these sensors, along with the sensors, we will be also throwing the X-ray light through this circular thing. And then you have a linear rod like this. This linear rod will be having a linear motion, that is front and backward, and we will throw the X-ray light on this linear rod. Then that X-ray light will pass through the object, which is there on the linear rod, and will be collected back by the sensors, which is there at the other end. So such arrangement we have already seen, if you remember from the previous classes. It was seen in your CAT machines, which is nothing but CT scan machines, which stands for computerized axial tomography. If you have studied in detail in the previous classes. So hereby, what we'll be doing now, we'll be generating a 3D image. Then very important thing here is, whatever you are seeing here, these are nothing but the mechanical aspects. This same thing will be passed to your software modules, wherein we're using those software modules, we'll be reconstructing those sections of images which we have received through this arrangement. So like this, we'll be receiving n number of sections. These n number of 3D images will then be clubbed and will be creating a one single image. You can say these are stacked images. We'll stack all these images and we'll create one single image. So this is how your whole thing will be obtaining. So this here rod, whatever you can see, it is nothing but the on this an object will be lying. Object is nothing but the patient. Okay. So this is all regarding your circular sensor strip. So I hope you understood the difference between your single sensor and the circular sensor. So single sensor generates 2D images, and the circular sensor generates the 3D images. Okay, so here I will end my class, friends. In the next class, we'll go ahead with the rest of the things. So I hope I'm clear with today's class. If you have any doubts, any problems, you can WhatsApp me on my.